Hi, it's Vicky here with my monthly feature, making the most out of the Simons & Stamp card kit. In the October card kit, you get all those sticker acorns. These are really puffy and very realistic. You also get two ink pads by Ranger. These are archival inks, so they are permanent. You get a clear stamp set full of leaves and perfect for fall cards, as well as pattern paper. This is pattern paper full of beautiful designs with lovely colors for fall cards. There are 12 pattern papers, 6x6. You also get three pre-scored standard cards, that's 4.25 by 5.5, after you fold them. I am going to use my bone folder and make sure that I have a nice crease there. And these cards are made out of Simons & Stamp heavy white cardstock, which is actually my favorite, and that's the one that I use for my card bases. So you also get three different colors of cardstock, and since with the cardstock included in this kit you end up with 9 card bases, I am going to cheat and add one more from my stash. For my first card, I'm going to use this die, and with a pencil I'm just going to draw a ring. And I made sure that I wasn't pressing too hard with my pencil. And the idea is to create a wreath, so I am going to use all those little bits and pieces from the stamp set, along with 4 Simons & Stamp ink pads that I have chosen especially to match fall colors. So I'm just picking some of the leaves that are included in the kit, and I'm just going to stamp along the ring that I have just drawn. So I don't mind if I cover up the line. Actually, this is exactly what you want to do. You go all along the pencil line, making sure that at the end you won't be able to see that pencil line. I am switching colors, and I am going to continue adding more and more, making my wreath as full as I want to. And as I am stamping, just to let you all know that there is a giveaway on my blog, so if you want to win this October card kit by Simons & Stamp, make sure to visit my blog and enter your details. You will find a link down below in the description area. For my sentiment, I went with Autumn Greetings, and I am going to stamp it at the bottom of this panel. Now, just to embellish my panel even more, I decided to add those acorns, so I am actually covering up the acorns that I have stamped previously. And I am also going to create a bow out of this orange ribbon, and I'm going to stick it on top of my wreath by using a glue dot. And just to remind you that you can find a full list of all the supplies that I'm using today just below the video in the description area. I am also going to make sure that I link you to some of the products separately in case the card kit is sold out by the time you watch this video and you want to grab some of those goodies. So with some tape adhesive, I have stuck this directly on my card base. So for this card, I have already created this panel by using a rectangle die as well as a ring die. And I am just going to use my pencil and draw a pencil line along the hole so I know where this is going to fall at the end. And now this is where I am going to put the sentiment. I'm going to emboss the sentiment with Ranger embossing powder, and that's orange. So I am stamping the sentiment first with Versamark ink, and now I am going to apply my embossing powder. And I really love the effect and the contrast of how that orange looks against that brown cardstock. So I am now using my heat gun to melt the powder. And I'm using an eraser just to make sure that this pencil line is not going to show through that window. Now, just to make my card a little bit more interesting, I have chosen one of the leaves from the stamp set, and I'm going all around the area that is going to show when I stick the panel on top. I am also making sure that I rotate the stamp so that it doesn't look so repetitive. Now I'm going to apply some clear embossing powder, which is going to give me a tone-on-tone look. This way I will end up with an interesting background, but at the same time it's going to be quite subtle. I have used my heat gun to melt the powder and now I'm preparing my window. So I have covered up the hole with acetate and I'm also going to create a frame by at the back of the panel by using my foam tape. I have combined metallic glass glitter by Prima along with some sequins in different colors that match fall perfectly, and now I'm going to peel off my foam tape and stick it directly on top. And just to add a little bit more contrast and detail, with those two dies I have created a ring. I am using my glue pen at the back and I'm going to stick it directly on my panel. So through the window you can see the greeting, and at the same time you can shake all those sequins. For the third card I'm going to use leftovers from the previous card, and I'm going to use those banner dies, which I have cut out a couple of banners. Now directly on my card base I am stamping the sentiment that says "Nuts about you." And I'm going to decide where I want to place those banners and stick them down. Now for the smaller one, I'm going to stick it directly with adhesive, so it's totally flat there. But for the bigger one, I'm going to add tape adhesive at the top. But at the bottom, I'm going to add a little bit of foam tape. So this is going to raise the bottom and add a little bit of dimension. I am also going to curve the edges. And once I'm happy with the placement, I'm going to use my scissors and cut out the excess. Now in the stamp set there are two cute squirrels, a big and a smaller one. So for this card I'm going to stamp the bigger one. And since I am using Simon's stamp ink, I know that I have a few seconds to apply some embossing powder. So I am applying clear embossing powder, which is just going to turn that squirrel into a shiny element, which I think is perfect for adding your own embellishments on your cards. I'm going to cut the squirrel with my scissors, making sure that I leave a white border. If you don't feel confident about that, you can just draw a line first and then follow the line to cut it out. I'm fine by cutting it directly, so I'll just go ahead and do it. And I have also used this blue pattern paper to cut out another banner, which I am going to stick on top of the rest of the banners by using some foam tape. So this one is totally raised. I am cutting off the excess and I'm going to stick the squirrel on top of those banners. I'm using some foam tape at the back. And I'm going to stick one of those acorns. Now this wasn't staying in place, so I decided to add one more foam square. And this is going to make it secure. And it's not going to go anywhere. So my card is pretty much finished. I decided to add one more finishing detail. So with my white gel pen, I'm going to do some faux stitching. For this card, I'm going to combine the greeting that says "Nuts about you" with the U die. So instead of stamping the U at the end, I'm going to use this die cut. I have cut it out of this pretty pattern paper, and I'm also going to cut out U out of this fun foam. So then I'm going to stick one on top of the other, and this is going to create a nice raised and thick die cut. I really love adding that into my cards. They make a great difference in real life. So I'm just making sure that everything is nicely lined up. And I hope you can see how nice and thick that die cut is now. Now I am going to cut out the word "you" out of this pattern paper. And once that's cut out, I have used my die cutting machine for that. I'm using my T-ruler and I'm going to draw a line. You can see that I have already drawn one line, but I decided that it was way far up, so I'm drawing it again. And with my scissors, I'm going to cut it out. And this is going to be a panel, which I am going to stick at the bottom of my card base. I'm using the white card base for this card, and you can see how nicely the word "you" fits inside. So now that I have checked the placement and I'm happy with how everything is looking. I'm going to add some tape adhesive at the back. I'm making sure that I'm very careful as I apply that so I don't tear up this paper. And I'm also using some glue with my glue pen for the tiny little bits. I'm going to stick it at the very bottom of my card base. And now I'm going to stamp the big square again. I am using archival ink, and that's a sepia color on one side. And you can see that I made a mistake. I didn't stamp perfectly there, but that's nothing that you cannot fix. I'm just dabbing a little bit. And I fixed that dot there. So anyway, I am going to place the U right in place so I know where I'm going to stamp the rest of the sentiment. By the way, I have cut out with my scissors the word U for that sentiment. If you don't want to do that, you can just mask off the word U. Now I'm going to stick the die cut on my card, and I decided to use Glossy Accent instead of my glue pen just to make sure that this is going to stick nicely there. I am also going to stick down the inside of the letter Y. And now I am going to use the tiny little acorn that's inside that stamp set, along with the tiny heart. And I'm going to make them coming out of the squirrel. And I am also going to create my own enamel dots by using the Nouveau Crystal Drops. So I'm making some bigger and other smaller ones, and I'm just filling in the gaps. So this pretty much finishes the card. I have also added some glitter on my squirrel. So now let's move on to the fifth card. This is quick and easy, and I'm just going to use some post-it tape to mask off an area from this white panel. I am going to use bits and pieces from the stamp set, along with those three ink pads. The two are from the stamp set, and the third one is archival ink in sepia color. And I'm going to stamp at the top and at the bottom of this post-it tape. Now I'm going to continue switching little leaves and pieces from the stamp set, and I'm going to switch from one color to another. Pretty much just like I did for the red card in the beginning of this video, but this time instead of working in a ring, I am working horizontally. You can make it as full as you want, and once I was happy with the stamping, I'm going to peel off, and so you can see that I have the perfect area to stamp my sentiment. With the same sepia archival ink, I am going to stamp in the middle the sentiment that says Autumn Greetings, and I am going to stick this panel with some foam tape at the back directly on my card base. For this card, I'm using the orange card base. So the card is pretty much finished, quick and simple. For the next card, I'm going to use distress markers, and you can see here on screen all the colors that I'm using, and I'm going to be working on a watercolor paper. For this technique, you will also need your spray bottle. Now I'm going to first color the acorn, and I'm going to use the thick tip from the distress markers. I'm going to use the colors and apply some color directly on the stamp. And using the markers, the tip of the marker makes it super easy to apply the color exactly where you want to. I have stamped the acorn on the card that I have pre-sprayed with water. So this is going to give you a nice watercolored look. So I'm doing it again, exactly the same thing, using the same markers. And this time I'm spraying directly on the acorn instead of the card. So you end up with the same result pretty much. I just wanted to show you that both ways work for this card. Now I'm going to repeat the same process and again until I'm happy with the amount of acorns that I have stamped. And I'm going to do exactly the same with the green markers to stamp the leaf. So I'm blending the two markers directly on the stamp. Spray with water and stamp. Now, if you want to enhance that watercolor look, you can spray directly with water. So this is going to help all that ink to bleed a little bit more. Depending on how much water you apply, this is going to bleed even more. So now that everything is wet, I can go back and add some details with my markers. Remember that my paper is wet and that's why I am able to do that blending. I'm going to do the exact same thing of blending on my leaves as well, just to add a little bit more shadow and detail there. And I have to say that this one is my favorite of all 10 cards that I have created today. And I really love this technique and I'm sure that I am going to be using it again and again in the near future. I'm also adding some splashes, and that's the exact same color that I have used for my acorns. And to assemble my card, I am using some tape adhesive at the back of this panel. This is the pattern paper from the kit. And as my card base, I'm using the Orange card base. And I'm going to add some foam tape at the back of my panel. Now all that's left to do is to add the sentiment, and for that I am going to stamp Natty Over You in this dark brown cardstock. This is a scrap cardstock that I have from my stash. I'm stamping it with Versamark ink and I'm going to apply white embossing powder, and then I have used the thinner banner die to cut it out. This comes from a banner dies set that is really versatile, and I think that I will be using it again and again, and you will find a link on that set down below. I'm going to stick that with foam tape at the back. You know I love dimension. And my card is finished. For this card, I'm going to use this lone foam die that cuts out a Polaroid frame, and I'm going to use both pieces from this cutout. So in the square, I am going to do some stamping with Versamark ink, and then I'm going to apply some white embossing powder. So I'm going to switch from different leaves on my stamping block, and once I have filled up the whole square, I have applied my embossing powder and heat set it. Now you won't be able to see anything, but now everything is going to be revealed as I am applying my distress ink, and that's because embossing powder resists distress ink. I'm going to use three different colors, and I'm going for an ombre look here, but you will see that once I went ahead and applied Rusty Hinge, it didn't do much difference from Spiced Marmalade. So this is what I mean here. So I'm going to use a darker ink pad, and that's I believe Vintage Photo, and I'm going to switch from one color to the other until I'm happy with the blending and everything looks smooth. This white cardstock is Simon Says Stamp heavy cardstock, and you will find a link down below in the description area. I'm using T-dye ink to ink up the edges of the Polaroid frame on the outside and on the inside of the frame, and I'm also going to stamp the sentiment at the bottom of my Polaroid frame. Out of the brown pattern paper, I have cut out a panel that's a 4.25 by 5.5 panel that is going to cover up the whole card base. I am inking up the edges again, and that's a Vintage Photo. And I'm going to stick that directly on my card base with some tape adhesive. So once that's there, I'm ready to assemble the whole card. I have added some foam tape at the back of the Polaroid frame, and out of the scraps that I have from the previous cards, I have created a few banners. I'm just using my scissors to create fish tails at the end, which I'm going to stick at the back, and that's just to add an extra element on my card and add a little bit more color. So I'm going to stick that directly on my card base, and my card is finished. For this card, I am playing with this pattern paper, and with those three different sized dies, I'm going to create three different holes. So I have passed it through my Sizzix machine, and now I'm going to place it directly on top of my white card base. With my pencil, I'm going to draw those circles, and that's because I want to know where everything is going to fall. Now I know where all the holes are, and I'm going to stamp the big squirrel in the big hole. And to make it more interesting looking, just like I did in a previous card, I'm going to apply some clear embossing powder. And again, this is going to make it look shiny. So I have applied my embossing powder, I'm going to use my heat gun. And for the tiny little hole, I decided to use my scissors and from the scraps to cut out a heart. But this didn't go very well, so I used instead the punch to punch out this tiny little heart. So no, I haven't cut out with my scissors that perfect cut out heart. Anyway, I am sticking it down, and for the middle hole, I am going to use one of those acorn embellishments. So now I'm ready to stick the panel on top, but first I need to make sure that those pencil lines are not going to show through those panels. This is not going to be a shaker card, it's just going to be a window card that you can see inside. So I haven't used any acetate on the holes, but I did use foam tape at the back just to raise the panel a little bit. So all that's left to do now is to add the sentiment. And I just stamped it and create a fish tail on one side. For this card I used two different pattern papers, and I have also used this die to create those four square windows. Now one pattern paper is slightly smaller than the other one. I am using some foam tape at the back just so that I have the top panel raised against the background. And I'm going to stick it directly on top. Now for the inside of those windows, I'm going to use the three acorns that I have left, along with those three leaves that are nice and shiny. They came in a pack of sequins. So now I am going to stick them down with glue dots, one of each in each square. I'm just making sure that I don't stick them directly in the same position, so one square slightly differs from the next one. And I have a nice embellished card. All that's left to do is to add the sentiment. For that I'm just stamping one of the sentiments that says "Thank you for everything." I'm using Versamark ink with white embossing powder on a piece of scrap piece of paper that I had left over from that panel. I am going to stick that directly on top of my card base by using some tape adhesive at the back. And that finishes this card. For the last card, I'm going to create with my Copic markers a branch. So I'm using three different colors of Copic markers, and I'm just showing you how I draw it. You can see the three colors on screen right now. And I'm working on white heavy Simon Says stamp cardstock that I have cut out by using a tag die by Hero Arts. Notice how I am keeping the darker color at the bottom of the branch while the lighter color is at the top. So this is going to create the illusion that this is a nice dimensional and round. And once I'm happy with that, I'm going to stamp the leaves. So I'm going to choose one of the leaves that come in the set, and I'm just going to stamp them at the end of the branch and in the middle. So now I'm happy with how that looks. I am going to stamp the little squirrel now. And of course I'm going to place him standing on that branch that I have created for him. So for this card I'm going with a little scene, and I'm also going to give this little guy an acorn. And to finish off my little scene I need to create the sky. So with this old cloud punch I have punched out three clouds and out of masking tape. So I'm just deciding where my clouds are going to be, and then with my distressing and finger dabber I'm going to apply some ink on the background. The ink that I am using is Broken China, and I have applied heavy color at the bottom, and as I go to the top I apply with a lighter finger. So once I'm happy with the color that's on the tag, I'm going to peel off the clouds, and I'm going to stamp the sentiment with black ink at the bottom of the tag. And I went with Natty Over You. I'm going to use my crocodile to punch a hole at the top of my tag. And my tag is pretty much ready. Now all I need to do is to assemble my card. Of course, I just had to add a little bit of Wink of Stella. So for my tag, I went with the blue card base and I have matted my tag with this piece of pattern paper. Now I'm using my heart punch to punch out a few hearts from the orange parts of that pattern paper, and I'm going to stick them down. I'm using my glue pen for that, and I'm really in love with this glue pen. I think it's so easy to use, and I keep going back to it again and again. Also notice how I am applying some glitter on top of those hearts, as well as some glossy accents or some glaze. That's the same product pretty much. And I have also thread some brown ribbon through that hole at the top of my tag. So that finishes the last card for today. And now let's take a look on all 10 cards that I have created today. And now let's take a look at the leftovers. Of course, I have the two ink pads and the stamp set for my stash, Great Stash Builders. I have three 6x6 pattern papers that I haven't touched. So here are the close-ups of all the 10 cards that I have created today. I hope you had fun and got inspired. And if you did, don't forget to leave me a comment, as well as give me a thumbs up on my YouTube channel. And don't forget, if you love this video, share it with your friends. And if you need more inspiration, here are two more videos that I am creating 10 cards out of the Simon Says Stamp card kit. Thank you all for watching!